Tomorrow, I am going out for a day-long journey. And to be frank, I am more excited than worried about it. But what I am worried about is this. Because when I am absent, someone can easily break into my premises and steal these poor guys. Although these are not worth much, they carry a high emotional value for me. That is when I thought about making a homemade security system with things I have laying around. In this video, I will show you how I made an easy to make but yet versatile home security in less than 24 hours. For this project, you require the following: a Raspberry Pi. Yes, it could be a cheap Raspberry Pi Zero, an SD card of at least 8 GB memory, some sort of camera, could be a USB camera, an IP camera, or even a Raspberry Pi camera, and you also require an Wi-Fi connection. Apart from this, of course, you need a computer and a card reader. In this project, we will be utilizing Motion iOS written by Chris. So go to their official repository, link in the description. First, download the latest OS. Then follow the steps there to burn it into your SD card. You can use the software of your choice to burn, or like me, you can just follow the instructions there. Once the bootable SD card is prepared, insert it into the Raspberry Pi, connect your cameras and power your Raspberry Pi. Your Raspberry Pi will automatically connect to your Wi-Fi network, so you have to find its IP address. For this, I simply go to the portal of my Wi-Fi router, and somewhere in the menu, I will find the DHCP clients that are being connected to the wireless network. So here you can see Motion Eye is connected to my Wi-Fi network. Enter this IP address into a web browser. The default username is admin and the password field should be left blank. Motion Eye has automatically detected my two cameras. Congratulations, your Motion Eye is now running. Now, to remotely view these videos from anywhere in the world, you have to do something called port forwarding. Why? Simply put, your router will not allow someone from an external network to view the files streaming in the local network. If you look closely, you can see that Motion Eye is already streaming the video in the port 8083. So, for port forwarding, once again, go to your router's portal and somewhere in the advanced settings, find port forwarding. Add new port forwarding settings and give a custom name. As server IP address, you have to give the IP address of Motion Eye. At this point, you will have to change your Motion Eye's IP address into a static IP, then DHCP. Now, at external port start, I will enter 8081 and port end, I will enter 8084 so that I can have 4 cameras at the end. Now, to check whether the port forwarding was successful, go to port check tool. There, enter the port you just forwarded, and if everything went right, it will show successful. You can use this port and the public IP address that you can see here to view your video footages from anywhere in the world. I am switching off Wi-Fi in my mobile phone and connecting to mobile data. And if I try to connect to this port, I can access it. But there is still a problem. The problem is that your public IP address will not be static unless you are a premium broadband consumer. So, your internet service provider will be forcing your router to change its IP address at least once in every 24 hours. A simple solution to the problem is to keep track of your IP address every time you go out. Not impressed? Well, you can automate it. For that, you have to use a dynamic DNS service. They are free for the most of it. I will use NoIP in this example. Open a new window, go to noip.com and sign up for a new hostname. It is pretty straightforward. Once you have that, once again go to your router's portal and somewhere in the advanced settings, find Dynamics DNS service and add the details there. Now, what NoIP will do is keep track of your public IP address and link it to the domain name mailail.ddns.net. Whenever your ISP changes your IP address, NoIP will link the new IP address to your domain name. Pretty neat, right? So, we have successfully set up remote monitoring. Next, we can move on to setting up motion notifications. Motion Eye can send you email notifications whenever there is a motion. Pretty handy in my case. For this, scroll down to motion notifications, enter the recipient email IDs, your SMTP server and port, your mail ID and its password, and activate TLS. Before testing, there is a little step to do. Go to Google and search access for less secure apps. Open the first link you get and enable it. You will get a security warning. Just ignore it. That's it. Test email and apply the changes. Now you are ready to receive motion notifications. Now, just getting motion notification might not be enough for you. You can make Motion Eye upload the footages just after the motion detection to your Google Drive. For that, just type in a folder name. This folder will appear in the root of your Google Drive and give authorization for Motion Eye. You can make Motion Eye periodically clean your drive, i.e. the subfolder where the footages are uploaded, and give authorization. It is very straightforward. Now, do not think that Motion Eye will only record when it is motion triggered. It can also record continuously like normal CCTV cameras. If that is what you want, make sure you use a large SD card. And as said earlier, you can make Motion Eye clean the old files periodically. But like me, if you are only going to record when there is a motion, make sure to put the maximum movie length to a small value, as you don't want Motion Eye to wait and record the whole drama and upload only when everything is over. With that, I end the first part of this video. In the next part, I will show you how I made these wireless IP cameras for cheap, and I will also show you how you can do most of these without a Raspberry Pi. So stay tuned. See you next time.